So I got the bike on its back. I'm going to start by just taking off the front wheel for the install. So loosen it up. Also note the left side of the bike is this side. So this side is going to be pointing up when I bring it over to the table. So I'm just going to put my left hand on it to make sure. Okay, to make life a little easier, I've got a roll of tape that I use to steady the wheel. So wheel down on the tape, valve facing you, and remember the left side of the wheel right now is facing fully upwards. So grab the front set of lights. You know the front set because the front set has the white stickers for white lights. And notice the difference in the rings. There's the battery ring, which has this cable. And then there's the passive ring, which has a socket for that cable to go into. The battery ring needs to be on the rider's left. So I'm going to grab this one first and just go ahead and lay it down onto the bike wheel. These brackets are going to each straddle a spoke. And then what I try to do is center these two brackets on the valve, which makes filling up the tire a little easier. So let's start with there. The next step is to go ahead and grab your spoke mounting hardware, which is right here. Also note that on the hardware, there's going to be a side that has the nut showing, the side that is a hole for the screw. And then there's a flat side, which is the top, and then a side where the attach point's exposed. So you want the flat side facing out towards the rim. And to make life easier, I'm going to have the hole side facing up, which is where the screw is going to go, and just go ahead and snap it on in four positions where those mount brackets are. Okay, now with that done, go ahead and grab four long screws. So that's these screws here, and just screw them gently into the hole so that they stay in place. Okay, and with that done, lift up the ring and slide those mount brackets, those spoke clips under the mount brackets. So now I'm going to rotate the bike so that the battery is facing me. I'm going to grab the passive ring and find that socket that's going to line up with where the battery is. Lift the wheel, put the ring under, and then we're going to plug the cable in. So the easiest way to do this is, you notice the spoke that we're attached to. There's one more spoke next to it, and then I'm going to loop this around that second spoke and plug it into the passive ring. One other cool thing about our new model is the battery is incorporated in the ring, which means you can immediately test it. So now that the rings are plugged together, I'm going to grab the battery. You insert the contact end first and then press till you hear a click to install it. And then you can just click the button and check. You got four lights coming on the top, and the same four lights should come on the bottom. I'm going to turn that off so I don't shine it in my eyes on the later steps, and start engaging the rings together. So to do this, you want to take the two mounting points and they should slot together really easily. And then go ahead and slide the mounting bracket into place, or the spoke adapter into place to kind of hold those things together. And I'm going to go around and do that in all four positions. Okay, so now this loosely held together, I'm going to go ahead and grab now the short screws and insert them to attach the rings together to the spoke clip. So let's go ahead and pull that so that the screw should screw in easily. And in this point, I'm not going to tighten down anything. I'm just going to get it to the point where it's loosely attached. We're actually going to tighten everything down once it's actually on the bike. Okay, so at this point you should have all the screws in and everything is still very loose. We're going to move it over to the bike to tighten everything down and get it all aligned. So before you put your wheel back on, make sure the battery is still facing left. If I turn the lights on, the light should actually face towards the bike because the bike is upside down. If you were to then switch the bike to be right side up, the lights would then be facing the right direction. So this is correct. I'm going to turn the lights off and start the next step, which is aligning the ring both left and right so that the light can shine past the tire, but also concentrically on the wheel. So I'm going to give it a quick spin and just see how straight the rings are put on. It looks like it wobbles a little bit concentrically and quite a bit left to right. So let's start with the left to right. What you want is to be able to see, if you look end on the tire, both LEDs when the LEDs are looking at you. And the reason is that then the light can shine past the tire. So I'm gonna go ahead, that looks pretty good there. So I'll tighten down these first two screws. Okay. And noting how much visibility I have, I'm gonna go to the next mounting point and adjust that to be the same. And you're just going to want to go ahead and do the remainder the same way. And last one. Okay, with that, give it a quick spin and see how straight it is. Actually looks like I got it pretty good, so I'm going to leave it there. Now that I have those screws tightened, the shorter screws, I'm going to check the concentricity, which looks like there's a little bit of a bump, so this needs to probably be pushed in a little bit and this one pulled. So do that, get it to the point where it sits, and then if it looks okay, which this should be passable for now, I'm going to go ahead and tighten those long screws. And this cinches those mount points down onto the spokes, locking the ring into place. So with that, all the screws should be tightened now. I'm going to go ahead and mount the magnet. So the way the magnet works, if I were to spin the wheel slowly, you see the light is staying in the right spot. But the moment you start spinning it quickly, the light will dance around and around. And that's what the magnet helps to fix. So if I grab my magnet and just sit it right on the ring so it passes the sensor, if I give it a really good spin, now it's aligning itself properly, which would be the forward direction. So that looks like a good spot for the magnet. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my zip ties. And it's really simple, just one zip tie through each end of the magnet. And stick it right back on the fork, which looked in a good spot, which was here for me. And I will zip these down. Slide the magnet into the right spot, which is right centered on the ring. Tighten that, and let's see if it was good. Perfect. So the light is shining straight forward, and you can see there's projection past the tire. So I'm going to trim up the wires, but otherwise this installation is good to go.